Australia stands with India during this difficult time. India managed the first wave of the pandemic so well, and we're all behind them. And we've had such a good travel and movement of people from India to Australia and back and forwards, even during a very difficult pandemic. But what we see now is 300,000 cases a day. We see so many terrible deaths that the health advice in Australia has put India into a high-risk category. So the government has had to act. We've temporarily paused those flights. But while we do that, we're going to consult heavily with the Australian community about the situation in India, with our agencies, with DFAT, and do whatever we can to protect vulnerable Australians who are in a very difficult, as you say, war zone within a very serious pandemic. Well, we're consulting heavily about how we will do that. Sometimes it's not just at our end. People have to get to airports at both ends. There are logistic things to manage. So we're going to take the time up to May 15 to consult heavily, to work with our officials offshore, to look at the arrangements here. And we've made some strong announcements about this. For example, they'll need two negative COVID tests to get on a plane, because we've received advice that of all the cases we've been having here in Australian quarantine, the vast bulk of those have been from India itself. So we have to protect Australia, but we also have to continue to manage vulnerable people who are over there who need to return to Australia. Well, it's temporary. It's only a pause on flights. No one's blocking Australians returning. It's a temporary pause while we work out logistical arrangements. And the government's made some pretty significant announcements already about how we'll do that, with two separate negative COVID tests, how we might then manage quarantine. All of these things have to be sorted out with the best health advice. And we're certainly confident that we're doing everything we can to protect Australia. Well, the National Cabinet has been looking at these things over the course of the last year. They have to be robust models, they have to be well-resourced models, and it's a constant tension between the health advice and what we can and can't do as a federation. But we've done so well compared to everywhere in the world. We've got to recognise here that there's thousands of people dying every day in India. There's over 200,000 people will have died now at least, and they have a second wave, which is 300,000 cases a day. So, you know, we have to keep this in context, that we are doing everything we can to protect Australia. We're helping out countries in our region, but we're also making sure we look after vulnerable people who can return as quickly as possible.